Hey guys, and welcome back. This is TK bringing you guys another episode of Tk-Kraft. Yeah. Okay, so in this episode, I am actually going to be working on the area where the village is. Now, I've already started doing some, renovations, I guess. Like, I've already built a entire wall around, and it's too thick. And that is because in a later episode, I am going to do something really cool. I've got a lot of plans for this wall. And the inside is not going to stay grass. I do plan on changing it to some sort of wood. Like, I went out and I got a bunch of oak wood from, I think, over there. But, yeah. So I'm going to make the floor possibly oak, possibly jungle wood. Just depends on what it looks like once it's done. Now, with this, it's going to be really cool once it's fully done, and I'm actually going to probably over this area here probably build, you know, some sort of new structure, because everything's all condensed over there. And I actually just finished putting in, well, fixing that path right there, and basically all I did was dug up a bunch of the gravel that was there, and underneath was this, so I put dirt underneath it and then put the layer of the cobblestone, and that's all it is. But I was toying with some looks for the outside of the wall, and I want to know what your guys' opinion is. Hang on, let me take this out real quick. Okay, pretty much I want to have it like this, and I will have that all the way around. Like, every four or five, I'd say, it's going to look like that. Now, I'm not going to have it on the actual ground, like, since I'm going to be having this, what is it, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 high, I'm going to have it in the two middle. Okay. Let me eat real quick. But I was just toying with some looks, because the location that I'm at, my iron farm is right over there. Well, not right over there, but, you know, just out of range of what it needs to be so my iron farm can still run properly. But I do plan on eventually moving that. Dang it, I should not have done that. Because for this episode, I'm actually going to be putting in the street lamps and things like that, and possibly starting to lay down the flooring of all this. I have yet to put a wall on the outside just yet, but I wanted to get the street lamps up and all that kind of stuff. And this is the build that I've gone with. I know it's not nighttime, but with this, it looks really cool. Plus, it lights up a lot. It just makes it extremely simple, yet fun at the same time, I guess. So I'm actually going to be laying the pathway of cobblestone all the way to every house. I really like the look. Like, the dirt or the gravel looks good and all, but, you know, I like the look of the cobblestone. So, how I do this is I take fence posts of just, you know, whatever type of look you want. Come on, there we go. There's that. And I go 4 high. And after the 4 high, let me get back down. On the very top one, I just put 2 fence posts, so that it looks like that. And then on the bottom of those, I just put 2 things of glowstone. And it actually lights it up pretty well. I still have yet to figure out how I want to light up the outside, like over there, you know, things like that. I still have yet to figure that out, but, you know, I'll eventually figure it out. And this is going to be difficult, so I'll put it here. Hopefully this works out well. Come on, there we go. And then, there we go. Okay, there's that and that, and get rid of that. So it's going to, like, the look of this at nighttime, nothing will spawn along the paths. And I'm actually going to be figuring out a way to... What are you doing? Anyways, I'm going to be figuring out a way to light up the rest of the village, because I still have zombies and stuff spawning in here, and it's not really good, just because I want to start breeding the villagers and all that kind of stuff, and I can't have zombies just coming in here and killing them all the time. So I think I actually might do this a lot, like, continue this all the way around, but only once it gets nighttime, that way I can actually see where I need new lamps and all that kind of stuff. I'm gonna take this out. This is really annoying. And all of my stuff has to be symmetrical. Like, all this is gonna be taken down, and all this... Well, I don't know about all this, but some of this is gonna be taken down as well, and it's just gonna be looking really cool. And I do not like that. That's probably how some of the villagers are getting up. So, oh, man. So, I believe, from what I have so far, is... Once it starts getting nighttime, he'll come in. I believe I have everything I need for... Oh, nope, I still need here. Alright, watch out, Mr. Villager. Go. Go. I don't think I have a farmer. It's really annoying. Because I need a farmer for... there we go. For breeding. So, yeah, I don't know. I might have one. I just haven't really looked around yet. So, there's that. There's that. And then I could put one here. Ooh, that's not going to be good. You know what? I'll put it. How do I want to do this? I'll put it. I don't know. This might look funny. I might have to change the look of this one. Just because I don't like the placement of it, you know? Like, I really like how they do some of their builds. Oh, yeah, see, I don't like that. I really like how they do some of their builds for the generated worlds, or for the generated villages, but a lot of the times I don't. Let's see, let me put that there, let me put that there. Okay, so now let me go down here. And since I'm going to be expanding it out this way, this is going to be even better, just so that I already have the... at least one lamp, or one lamp set up here. There's that. Okay. There's that. Alrighty. So, I think it should, like, the whole village itself should be set up besides, should I put one here? Yeah, I think I'll put one here. Let me fill this in real quick. Oh, and don't have any more dirt, so I'll just use gravel, whatever. And it's getting dark, so that's actually good, in, you know, except for in most cases where you don't want it to be dark when you're building or anything like that. Because when I was building the, or fixing the thing over there, oh yeah, see it lights up extremely well, but I need to put it, I think I need to put it here. Good thing I made a lot of these dang things. But yeah, when I was building the pathway, or redoing the pathway over there, I had a couple creepers come over and explode, but it was kind of good, just because you kind of needed it. So it was actually fairly helpful. Ooh, I can just jump up here. Nice. Dang it. There we go. I don't have my... Do I have my axe on? Oh, I do have my axe on me. Nice. Just because that looks funny. And I actually might end up putting those there. There we go. See? It's lit up really nice. Really well. And I'll have to put one over here just because, you know, things will spawn in over here. But this is all lit up fairly well. If you guys can notice, like, it's really actually fairly bright. It does wonders. I really like it. I kind of modified the idea from another YouTuber. See? And I'm still getting spawns, of course, just because it's all dark and stuff. And that right there is Optifine, if you don't know. It's amazing. Oh, come on, really? There we go. So, oh, he didn't drop his bow. But yeah, it is, as you can see, it lights up extremely well. I think it's a great idea. I was toying with it a little bit. And this is actually going to be the somewhat... What was that? I'm going to go in here. I'm actually going to be using this idea for the two lamps and all, or for the two lamps like that. Instead of two, I'm just going to have one. But it's going to be on my bridge, which is going to be really cool. Like, once I get that fully done and gather enough glowstone, I'm going to finish that off. But it's going to be crazy resource heavy just because how much glowstone I'm actually going to need. And that looks really cool. I never really stopped to look at the top of that house, or these houses. Like, look at that. That just looks amazing. Like, the patterns. Oh, can't make it. Oh, well. But, yeah, so this is my, you know, modified village lamp thing. Let's see. That's pretty much it for this episode, besides just, you know, working on the wall some more. So I'm going to go ahead and go to sleep and see if I have any more stone. And if not, I will cut out to go get some more stone. And this is the one. And once I get more stone, I will come in. Okay, let's see. Do I have any more stone? I have one. Stone bricks, sorry. Oh, but I have a bunch of stairs. You know what? I'm actually... What is that? Spruce? You know what? Let's go ahead... Oh, I can use that one in here. I'm going to go ahead and... check out the oak on the inside, and then if I like the look of that, then I will go ahead and continue with that look. And sorry about that, I just hit my hand on the desk. Okay, so yeah, this is the main reason why I did the inside, or do the outer wall, is because I don't like the look of that. Okay, so let me, and I did enchant this shovel. It's in efficiency 5 or 4, so it makes it look really, or it makes it really, really fast. Okay, it's not too bad. It was either between this or birch, but birch I think is too bright for something like this. So, but yeah, I think this is gonna look really good. Like, let me look. Yeah, I think it looks really good. Let me finish off this right here, just to be on the safe side. I'm not going to do the doorway just yet. Let's see. And if I really like the look of this, then I'm going to go ahead and continue with it all the way around, and then I will come back and show you guys what I have done. Let's see. I need more. Oh, yeah, and I still have to show you guys my bank. What I did with the bank. Okay, yeah, I like that. Alright, so I will be right back, and when I come back, I will have the entire floor laid out, so I will be right back. Okay, guys, and I'm back. And I'm actually in creative mode right now. I just wanted to fly around and show you guys what it looks like. But I got it all completely done. Like, as you can see, I got all the wood, and I did stick with the oak. And no, I was not in creative for putting all this stuff together. But yeah, so basically what the thing is going to be is, yeah, I know I'm in creative, but I will get rid of it. So basically, okay, let's see. Okay, so it's like that. And then basically what I wanted to happen is come up one more. And then I was going to, let me see if I can find one real quick. Whatever, that'll work. Okay, so all I was going to do was put two slabs just like that, and then have it go all the way around and ignore the fact that this is wood. But it's going to go all the way around just like that. And on top of that, I will have, where is it? cobblestone walls. That way, it will look more like a castle wall, I guess. But that's basically what it's gonna be once it's completely done. I think it's gonna look really good. I can't wait for it to be done. But yeah, that's what I'm working on now. And I'm not 100% sure if it's gonna be this, like a cobblestone wall or whatever, but I do want something like that. I might try to figure something else out depending on how everything goes. But I do need a lot more stone so I can turn it into. And the good thing is right here there is a ravine, so I can actually come down here and just start mining away. Possibly find some, there's a light thing right there. Possibly find, you know, some more diamonds. You never know. So I think I'm going to go ahead and get started on that, and I will... Oh, wait, no, I'm not going to see you guys in the next episode. I am going to show you guys what I have done with the bank. So once I get back to my home, which is over that way, I will catch back with you guys. So I will be right back. Okay, guys, so I am now back at my house slash treehouse thing, and I didn't want to show you guys it right away, and yes, I am still in creative just because I want you guys to see the overview of it, just because it's freaking huge. So let's go ahead and get started. Are you ready? Okay, so it's not all the way done, but it's close. Let me turn this off. Okay, so this is what I have done. It is huge. I have not counted how many items are here, but it's insane. So I'm really, like, I still, you know, have to go out and pretty much try to fill this thing. Rotten flesh, you know. But as you can see, these ones have a lot in them. And this is mainly because of my other project that I've been working on, and it has to do with clearing a lot of trees. And this is from all the quartz that I had got to get this, and the amount of quartz that I'm gonna need to finish this thing, this will honestly probably be full. Now let's go ahead and see how many chests there actually are. Okay, so there's a bunch. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So there's 7 chests. Now, this holds items, and this holds items as well. And so does the dropper thing. Anyway, so this is the mechanism I have to have everything go up the dropper system. That's why I had to turn off the switch, just because it's super annoying. And I really haven't done much with anything in here. I cannot remember why I have these lights here, but I do for some odd reason. I don't know. I cannot remember for the life of me. And as you can see, some creepers exploded when I was down here trying to set all this stuff up. So, and that goes to the chest in the dead center, which I will show you that now. And there's the chest. So basically what happens is I go into here, I drop some items in here, like all this dirt. And as you can see, it already starts taking it out. I threw the gravel in there as well. And where's the dirt? There's one that has dirt. Oh, and there, that's where I put my slimes. Okay. There we go. So, how this works is it goes down into the hopper below and goes all the way to that corner, goes up the system, and all the way around until it hits this one here. It'll stop, I think it stops actually right here. I'm not, oh no, never mind, it goes all the way. Oh yeah, because these ones over here. Okay, so it goes all the way over and then stops at this corner. And I've been fiddling around with some designs. I'm not 100% sure. I don't like this, but I mean, it's not bad for right now. I'm still trying to figure out for the roof design and everything like that, but I like how it's coming out. And all the way around, I had to make a platform, of course, and throw torches in here just because I didn't want anything spawning or anything like that. And if you guys remember, these are actually the sorting systems, or the item sorter system. Okay, now it's my kitty. Okay, so here we go. Time to go up and up and up and up and up, and look at that. That is crazy big. And that hopper system is insane. This thing took forever to build. I think just to get the walls and stuff up, like not including all this stuff, because I know like I pretty much built one entire system, skipped over one entire system, so on and so forth. But then once I got them all done, I had to pillar up and then place all these blocks. I think the whole thing, like, I think one of the hardest parts was putting all these hoppers here. That was a major pain. It honestly, just this alone, had to have taken me, geez, like, a good 6-7 hours just for the base. Like, not including the entrance or, you know, the surrounding the outside with all the courts and things like that, putting these pillars up. Yeah, it was crazy. And it's not even done yet. Like, it's close. It honestly is close, but it's not as close as I would like it to be. And I can't remember exactly what I was going to do with these part three. Oh, that's right. Okay. I remember now. Okay. So, but yeah, I really like how it turned out, and it works wonders. Let me go see if I can see it. Is it... Where's the dirt? Because how it had to happen... Where's the dirt? Oh, you know what? I don't even think this thing's on. Yeah, it's not on. Okay. So, yeah, it's not on. Okay. So, I actually did it wrong. Well, not wrong, but I misinterpreted when I was actually building this when I first started. And the reason why I say that is because once it gets, the item gets to where it goes down, it, the top light for some reason flashes. I don't know why. It's really annoying, but, oh crap, don't even tell me. Yeah, I don't know why it flashes. Let me see if I can find the dirt. Oh, dirt right here. Yeah, that's weird. Oh, yeah, it has to go all the way around. So, if I am correct, this thing, this top light should start flashing as soon as it starts going up. So, I just want to make sure that everything's working right. Okay, yep, see, there it goes. So, for some reason, and I could not debug it. I don't know why it does it, but it flashes every time something passes through that first chest. I don't know why, but other than that, it works, but I kind of like it, just because it's like, it gives you an indication that the items are actually going where it's supposed to. So I really, really do like it. It makes it really fun, and really cool. And then once it fills up, that light will stop. Like, once all the items have gone into the next chest up, so on and so forth. And as you guys remember, if you guys watched the video of me building this, these first three here, basically when this fills up and the two hoppers behind it fills up, and then the chest behind this light starts filling up, this light will turn on, and so on and so forth with all the other chests. So on that note, I am done here, and have a good day and take care, everybody. And I hope you guys like what you saw, and I really hope that you guys like the bank. And don't forget to comment about the design of my bank and things like that. And also what you guys think else I should do in the wrong button in the village. So I will see you guys next episode.